Welcome back, everyone, to live coverage here at Dell Technologies World 2025. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE with Dave Vellante, co-founder, my co-host of theCUBE, 15 years covering Dell. We got Greg Matson, Senior Vice President of Product at Solidigm, one of the hottest companies out there, innovative product solution, growing like a weed. CUBE alumni in the NYSE Wired community. Greg, thanks for coming on theCUBE, appreciate it.
Well, thanks for having us, it's exciting.
All right, first of all, people may or may not have heard of Solidigm, certainly in the tech industry where it's infrastructure, you're well known. Set the table, what's the most innovative thing you're doing? Why are you guys successful right now? What's the main product?
So, you know, firstly, is Solidigm was really born out of the memory and storage business at Intel. So we're kind of a startup company, if you'd say, but really a well-running startup, you know, kind of hit the ground running. And so we specialize in memory and storage products, and specifically kind of really brought the modern SSD to market for both PC and server usages. And now we're really driving and leading the high capacity storage for AI, you know, kind of revolution that's happening right now.
So everything's talking, we've been covering clustered systems now, AI factories, this demand for tokens, putting huge pressure on these clusters or AI factories, so enterprise, hyperscalers, neoclouds, whatever you want to call it, they need more systems, bigger systems.
Yep.
Memory's huge problem in this. And you guys partner with Dell, we're here at Dell Tech World, so you have PowerScale. What's the relationship with Dell? Talk about that first, and I want to get into some of the memory, why memory is more important now than ever before, but let's start with Dell.
Well, we've been a good, strong partner and close partner with Dell for, you know, way more than a decade in terms of storage and memory. And we've, you know, together as companies, driven new storage innovations, whether it was the, driving the PCIe interface for solid state storage, you know, versus SATA and SAS. You know, we did that, you know, maybe together, maybe 10 years ago. Yeah. And then, you know, started to drive high capacity storage, 30 terabyte, 60 terabyte, 120 terabyte to market. So we've been, you know, partnering with Dell, you know, across the board in storage for years.
So how are you interpreting the demand signals in the marketplace for AI training? You got inference, you have cloud scale workloads. How are you squinting through that, and how does that affect your NAND and SSD roadmap when you look out?
Well, you know, firstly, we started with our core technology, which was, you know, really ideally suited to be the best and highest capacity storage product in the market. And so we were doing that kind of before this big training wave. It was a portion of our business, but our technology that we had been driving was really kind of the, I would say, optimized for that use case.
And really good cost per bit.
Very good cost per bit, very good performance, reliability, power at the very highest capacities. And now, when training came along and people are starting to design new greenfield data centers, they don't want anything to do with legacy hard drives, right? They're way too slow, take way too much power, and take up a lot of space. So that there's a magic spot for us with our very highest capacity solid state drives.
So given the focus on cost per bit, what's your secret sauce to sort of balance the need for high performance and endurance? How do you guys, you know, it's historically, oh, you got to trade one for the other, but it seems like Solidigm has figured out a way to have its cake, eat it too, and not gain weight. Like, how do you do that?
I wish the weight gain was true. you know, first it comes down to our core memory silicon. So our NAND flash memory is based on what's called floating gate technology. And we were the first company to bring kind of in mass quad level cell or 4 bits per cell flash memory to the enterprise SSD market. So at the core, you know, the cost of a drive is more than 80% of the actual flash silicon itself, and we make the best quad level cell silicon on the map. And then we wrapped it around with a very cost and power efficient system and integrated those two together. And so we really pride ourselves on our media integration expertise and the ability to really extract the most out of what, you know, some people would call, you know, quad level cell might have lower endurance than other memory technologies, but we're able to actually increase the level of endurance at a system level and deliver almost a no compromise.
You're
product.
Like QLC magicians,
I
right?
Think
to close.
That might, it, right? I just asked them to be magicians, and people do it. Yeah. But yes, I think you're right.
We all love the SSD market. It's been changed the storage game for years. Just give us an order of magnitude of the scope of the impact. First, what's the products being featured here at Dell Tech? What's the capacity? You said it was 122 terabytes.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
That's huge. Scope, and then scope the impact and what that means in these systems. Because it makes sense to be a storage tier. Why have HBM, all this other most expensive stuff? Memory's critical in all this. Where does it fit in? So give us the numbers, what's being featured here at the show, and what's the impact in the infrastructure?
Okay, yeah, no problem. So we actually have a sample of our drive today. It's our 122 terabyte QLC drive. And we actually, you can see that the frame right here, we actually pulled this right out, straight out of a PowerScale system. So PowerScale is the first major storage system to go to market with 122 terabytes. Allows them to scale up to 6 petabytes per node, so massive capacity. And Dell's going to be rolling these things out in volume here pretty quick. And they launched them publicly maybe about a month ago.
Got it.
So our focus today is 122 terabyte, and look at that, it's like
beautiful.
122 terabytes the size of a pack of cards.
That is beautiful.
Look at that. That is really 122 terabytes.
All right, where does this
terabytes?
Fit? Obviously, we see where Dell
wow.
wins. So Dell got some good packaging, density's great. Okay, energy, all these core issues. In the architecture, the trend in the conversation is, it's not about the chips, it's what's around it.
Yep.
I hear storage fabric, network fabric, interconnects. What does this do for that kind of equation if someone's thinking about their data center as a computer?
Yep, yep. So really where the high capacity drives fit in is in the network attached storage. So there are drives, very, very fast Gen 5 SSDs in the GPU servers, but really those servers need massive amounts of data. I mean, petabytes and petabytes of data. In fact, some of the big greenfield data centers you read about it kind of every day in the
yeah.
press, they're buying exabytes of these drives. And because we really need to have yeah. A massive amount of data really adjacent to those GPU servers. And so by moving to high capacity flash storage instead of hard drives, you can save like 80% of the storage related power, which companies like Meta, Microsoft have said is up to 30% of the total system power. So 80% of that power. You can also yeah. consolidate racks, about 4x rack consolidation. And when you're building a data center optimized around GPUs, you want to save all the power, give all the power to the GPUs, you want to give all the space to the GPUs, all the real estate on your floor. And so this really allows allows companies to build optimized systems with very high performance, low power,
what
and
are some
efficiency.
Of the performance numbers? You have those stats handy in terms of like, because Michael Dell said in his keynote, cold storage has got to come and get warm and hot because
yep.
of the AI wants to
and
act
the
on
economics
the data.
Make it so attractive.
Absolutely.
So what are some of the numbers? That's going to create a huge lift for you guys. That means SSDs are perfect for warm and hot transition.
They bring data to life. If it's not on an SSD, it's essentially dead.
Give us an order of magnitude scope of, I got cold storage, old way, now I got these SSDs in there, they're tied right next to this high bandwidth system.
Yeah.
The throughput's got to be there.
You can imagine that this drive right here, just one drive has like a million IOPS. And so you think about a hard drive with maybe 200. So, and then there's 6 petabytes of one of these drives in the highest capacity Dell PowerScale system.
It's almost as big as my phone.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. It's very, very similar, right? And so, the scale of IOPS, the scale of bandwidth,
space, power, energy, performance,
yep.
and design for the systems.
Exactly.
That's where
exactly.
the action is.
Yeah.
So is that the reason why you're successful? Would you peg it? That's the reason why you guys are winning right now? I mean, your growth is phenomenal. Obviously, you came out of the big company is a separate company and you guys are like a startup within a startup.
Yep.
What's the reason why you're winning?
I think there's a couple of areas. First is, like I talked about, the media integration and knowing how to extract every last bit of performance and capacity and endurance out of the flash memory. But also, we spend an inordinate amount of time with our customers and it's customers across the globe. So, I've spent personally, years working with everyone I can find at Dell to understand their use cases and their end customers' use cases. And it's not just Dell, it's customers around the world, cloud customers, big customers, small customers. And we try to understand, you know, fundamentally, what are their pain points in storage? And then how can our technology help marry that, you know, help fix those problems?
I saw at GTC a demo with the cooling on top. Yeah. That's a very cool product. Give a plug for that thing. That's real.
Oh, that was it. So yes, in March we announced the world's first liquid cooled SSD. And we partnered, you know, we had, again, talking with our customers, and our partners, in this case, NVIDIA, and they had a problem. You know, at PCIe Gen 6, they needed a, you know, have a basically a liquid cooled system, not just on the GPUs, but the whole system, they needed to be fanless. And so we partnered with them. We actually had been doing a lot of pathfinding in both immersion cooling and cold plate cooling, and we designed the drive as well as the cold plate kit that the drives plug into.
Innovative.
To bring this to market, and now it's going to be part of their mainline reference
design. Is that shipping now?
It'll be shipping later this year, you know, with their next generation.
And what does that do from an innovation standpoint? Because, I mean, the historical Moore's Law would be, I don't know, call it, you know, doubling every 18 months, maybe roughly 40% a year. What kind of curve are you on? How does that direct liquid cooling affect that? Is it more for, you know, performance, for capacity, a combination?
It's kind of for performance and thermal and power, right? So what we have, and mostly not on the network attached storage, it's mostly on the GPU attached storage.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so those drives are in a very hot environment. They need, the GPUs are just begging for data, right? And so it's like every piece of, bit of performance that they can extract out of the drive, they need. And by running those drives at higher than kind of typical spec, so I can run this drive, that Gen 5 drive at like 30 watts, but because of the cold plate, the thermal dissipation is like running it at 15 watts. I get hundreds of thousands of more IOPS out of the drive, and you know, way more bandwidth out of the drive to feed the GPUs.
So Greg, I got to ask you a personal question. As SVP, Senior Vice President of Products and Marketing, you don't really need to do a lot of marketing. More product than marketing. I mean, the drives.
I do spend my time, inordinate amount of my time in product, because we got to get the product right, or I could market.
Pretty damn good product. Right. I mean, it sells itself. I mean, it's a lot of demand.
Yeah.
So, I mean, am I getting that right? There's a lot of demand? Is that because
there's a lot of demand, but there's still a lot of education to do. And that's why we're here, you know, talking about this stuff, because, you know, IT decision makers can't get to, you know, the data that they need. Yeah. They don't buy directly from us for the most cases. They buy through solutions providers. Yeah. And so how do we get the word out that, hey, if you're building, whether it's an edge data center, you have a small amount of space, a small amount of power, you need.
I mean, I would just hold the drive up and say, this is my iPhone Max, and that's a drive, it's 122 terabytes. If it works, you're going to buy it, right? I mean, who doesn't do it? All right, so I got to ask the verticals and the industries you're targeting.
Yeah.
Obviously, you're seeing Dell Street, it's kind of like, what's their theme, Main Street, all use cases. Every vertical's got AI. Are there certain industries right now that are more active than others? And can you give some examples of where you guys are moving the needle on these large factory configurations and just some data around how it's working?
Yeah, I mean, first and foremost, these big drives are being used in the greenfield AI data centers, right? Even the hyperscalers kind of have to make a transition off their existing infrastructure to something new. But when you're starting from scratch, you know what the best technology is, and you know that's where we're gaining a lot of traction. But you know, some of the cool end user stories are like, we worked with Dell and one of our storage partners called Peak AIO in the UK.
Yeah.
With a company called Mon.io, and it's actually an open source consortium that works with King's College, and they optimize algorithms and models for medical imaging. And so we work with them to reduce the medical imaging time for MRIs and getting the data back from your MRI from days to minutes. Awesome. So it's a real world application you know, that really benefits people, right? It benefits you and I if we were able to do that.
That's stress reducer right there.
Yeah.
Well, it can be sometimes weeks, you know?
Well, let's definitely get a drill down on that. We'll follow up, certainly in the Palo Alto studios, NYSC Wired studios in New York.
Yeah.
You guys are a great company, been seeing on the radar, obviously know the history. Congratulations on the success, and had a great deal with Dell. The price looked damn good.
Yeah, we have a great partnership with Dell. We're really thankful for it. And you know, you know, thank you for the congratulations.
All right, Craig, good to see you.
All right,
I'm John Furrier with Dave Vellante here live in Las Vegas for Dell Tech World 2025. It's like our 12th year covering Dell Tech World. Michael Dell was on earlier. More coverage after this short break.